Dear students, in today's class, let us start with encoders. In general, an encoder is a device that converts data from one format to another format. If at all we have n-bit binary encoder, it has 2 to the power of n input lines and n number of output lines. So for example, if at all we have 4 inputs, then we need to have 2 outputs. Okay, if you have 8 inputs, the number of outputs that are expected to be there at the output of the encoder is 3. Okay, the functioning of the encoder is just opposite to that of decoder. Okay, here is an example of how the truth table of an encoder looks like. See here, we have 4 inputs and we have 2 outputs. Okay, when D0 is high, the output is 0,0. When D1 is high, the output is 0,1. When D2 is high, the output is 1,0. When D3 is high, the output is 1,1. If all the inputs are zeros, the outputs are don't get terms. Right? Now, let us see how to design a 10-line BCD encoder. Right? While designing the decoder, we have seen how to design BCD to 10-line decoder. Now, we are understanding how to design a 10-line to BCD encoder. Now, when I say 10-line, the number of inputs that are expected to be there at the input is 10. Okay, and it is BCD. So, how many lines are expected to be there at the output? 4. Okay, so here is the truth table which tells the number of inputs and the number of outputs and the values that are supposed to be there for each of the decimal value. Right? So now, if for the value 1, okay, pin number 1 will be high, okay, and if you consider this ABCD output, A will become active. Okay, similarly so for the other values. Now, our next job is to design the combinational logic circuit. Now, if you consider the truth table here, students, D is the function, D has become low for the inputs 8 and 9, right? Now similarly, C is low for the inputs 4, 5, 6 and you can see here, the inputs are the C out is low for this particular combination of input, that is 4, 5, 6 and 7, right? It is similarly so with respect to B as well as with respect to A. Right? Now we understood that the relationship between output and input. Right? Now we have to write the K map. We have to further simplify it. Once we simplify it into getting the equation, then by using the equation we shall be drawing the logic diagram. Okay, so this is the logic diagram we are going to derive. Right? Now, so on the same lines, we can design octal to 3-line encoder. Okay, when you say octal, we will be having 8 inputs. The outputs are expected to be only 3. Okay, so what can be the values of input? The values of input can be anywhere from 0 to 7. Now, if I consider I0 to I7 as inputs and A0, A1, A2 as the output, okay, for these combinations of inputs, the outputs will be like this. So, for example, when I1 is high, the output is 001. When I2 is high, the output is 010. When I3 is high, the output is 011. When I4 is high, the output is 100. And it continues. Right? Now, so we have got the truth. We know the problem statement. We have written the truth table. The next job is we have to see the relationship between output and input. Okay? So, this is the relation that we are going to get. Okay, between output and input. Now, for this, we have to write the K map. We have to simplify the equation. And once we simplify the equation, this is the diagram that we are going to get. Right? So, this is about 8-line to 3-line encoder. Okay. Now, by using these encoders, we shall be able to connect the switches, a matrix of keypad switches, and we shall be able to get the BCD equivalent value for the value of the key that has been pressed. Say for example, if I am pressing 0 here, then I shall be getting the equivalent BCD value here. Okay, so this is one of the applications. You think of a keypad matrix, students, where we want to display the value that has been pressed, okay, on a display. Now, if at all we have one such requirement, what we have to do is we have to have a keypad and we have to connect that to a 10-line to BCD encoder in this particular way. And if at all we want that to be displayed in a 7-segment display, what we can do is we can connect the output of this BCD to 7-segment display decoder or driver, whatever you have studied in the previous class. Okay, we can have that IC over here. And the output of the decoder can be connected to 7-segment display. Right? If you have one such, whatever the key that we are going to press here, the appropriate signals will be activated, and this circuit will be able to give the equivalent BCD value, and the output will be displayed on the 7-segment display. Right? This is one of the application statements. Okay. So whenever you are entering some value in the mobile or in your calculator, you can see the value has been displayed over there. We do not use the 7-segment, though we use LCD display over there, but this is the functionality that takes place even in those circuitry aspects. Right? Now, so when we consider 8-line to 3-line encoder, here is the IC 74LS148. Okay, so this is the data sheet of 74LS148. Okay, so here, one second. So 74LS148, 54148, okay, these are all priority encoders. Okay, so here is the data sheet for it.